advantage of the so-called fight against corruption. I've clinched a deal with some imperialist organizations and also some funding coming from the UK meant to push an agenda of removing immunity of former President Edgar Chabalomba. As we speak now, there are surrogate labor movement leaders that have been paid colossal amounts of money to start, you know, speaking or proposing without any valid reasons to have the immunity of the former president lifted. They have been fishing everywhere, and they are taking advantage of President Hichilema's ignorance by presenting to him things which are actually normal within the operation of government. The recent laughable proposal that has been presented to him is that they took a document, which was basically him assigning to authorize Minister of Finance at the time to proceed with taking to Parliament a supplementary budget request, which was scrutinized by the then Budget Committee and eventually approved by Parliament. But they are giving Hakainde Hichilema half information, and they agitate him so that he can then give authority or permission for them to run with this so-called propaganda, whilst the target are the millions of pounds that have been ring-fenced to sponsor the so-called fight against corruption. But the underlying agenda of that so-called fight against corruption is that money will also come to be used to push the agenda of gays and lesbianism. The judiciary is being reconfigured, set in a manner that individuals will begin to go to court to start challenging the current law, whether it is consistent with conventions or indeed what they are calling human rights. First of all, Zambia is a sovereign state, and we are to govern ourselves and apply the law as prescribed by ourselves, the people of Zambia. This business of having foreign elements to dictate to us on how we should govern ourselves and how we should apply our own laws should come to an end. Ms. Hakainde Hichilema, he needs, at least for the first time, to prove to the Zambian people that he is not a puppet of the West. And the visit of Tony Blair did not come, he did not come here to hatch an agenda which is now beginning to manifest. If Ms. Hakainde is interested in the fight against corruption, he needs to look into the corruption of and the theft of the Mukula trees that is being cut at will in the northern province. As we speak today, Mukula is moving from Mpolokoso, from Mukula area, passing through roadblocks, escorted by some of the individuals from the security wings, which suggests that possibly he, as head of state, is part of that scam. Millions of kwacha, millions of dollars are being lost, whilst they are causing him to preoccupy himself with an imaginary belief that there was corruption under PF and there's a lot of money seated somewhere that they are hunting for. They have wasted already resources, public resources, traveling to, you know, countries across the globe. They have been to Turkey, they have been to Belgium, they have been to Dubai, they have been to South Africa, they have been to Switzerland, all in search of something they can use to pin on President Rumu so they can justify the removal of immunity. The other question we want to ask Mr. Kainde Hichilema, why is he casting a blind eye to the fertilizer scandal that has come to the fore, where a husband to one of his ministers is said to have blacklisted most of the business houses that are involved in the fertilizer business, and he got a contract by himself? And Misaka in the Hichilema had promised the Zambians that when he comes into government, the cost of fertilizer for him will reduce even up to the level of $450 per metric ton. But that contract is said to be costing us Zambians $1,000 per metric ton, which is even less compared to what was being purchased under patriotic front government. So, and we are also being made aware, zooming through the binoculars, that there are four ministers who have amassed wealth within these last 3 months by trotting from place to place, collecting money in the name of Mr. Kainde Hichilema. And these ministers now are stinking rich. And if he is not aware, let Mr. Kainde Hichilema ask his own members of parliament, particularly backbenchers, who have now begun to complain, saying that it looks like there is a clique in government led by Mr. Kainde and a few ministers, most of whom come from his region. We want to find out, how come this fight against corruption and the traveling of security personnel has become so lucrative that every time they go and agitate the president, no, we haven't finished the investigations, Mr. President. That is the way they are siphoning money and making money. So Home Affairs must give us answers. Ministry of Justice must give us answers. Local government and rural development must give us answers. And a number of those we know are in this clique that Mr. Kainde Hichilema must look into and find out whether or not what is referring to as corruption in PF is not kindergarten. There is grand corruption of international standard involving both kwacha, pounds, and indeed other foreign currencies. Well-schemed white-collar crime that is taking place now. So Mr. Kainde, remove the speck from the rogue in your eyes before you start looking to PF. Corruption is at your doorstep, and that is what is going on right now. Check about Mukula in Northern Province. Check about the fertilizer scandal, which I want to believe is actually orchestrated from your office, because instead of having the Attorney General approve the contract, the information we are getting through the operational binoculars suggests that the approval came from the head of state himself. And he has found himself in a bind, because the company for Mr. Janguru is failing to supply fertilizer because he has no capacity. And it is now becoming an embarrassment. With that said, thank you very much, members of the press.